All right, so I have a bit of a problem. All of my digital life is stored on multiple hard drives and multiple phones and laptops and SSDs and iPads, and everything is a mess. My backup of all of my life's photographs are out of date by like 2 years because there's just a folder of just organized by file names, and uploading everything is a mess and it sucks, and it's basically useless because I cannot actually access it from my phone or anything because it's just SMB and it's a mess. I think it's finally time to do the right thing and consolidate all of my mess of data onto one server and do it properly. So today we're going to build a server with some storage for all my data and Immich for my photo management and Samba and Minecraft servers and also VMs for gaming with the GPU pass-throughs and all that stuff. This is gonna be pretty hard, but let's see how it goes. Oh, this is what used to be my old PC. You might have seen it in some older videos of mine. The thing is, I really dislike desktop PCs. I prefer laptops, I like laptops, I don't really use this thing. So, what I did a couple of months ago, I actually think half a year ago, is I turned this into a kind of server. More specifically, a Mac server. Because even though I do know how to do server stuff, I don't like it. This is not my job, this is something that I just use. And, well, I didn't really use. Some of you might know what I'm talking about, but I often get that 2 week time period of my life where I wanna play Minecraft with my friends. So about a year ago, with a friend of mine, I started a new Minecraft world that is hosted on this thing. We didn't want to use one of those free hosting services because they're very slow and also, you know, they turn off automatically. So I was a bit sick of getting calls at 4 a.m. in the morning of my friend saying, hey, please turn on the server because I wanna play. So since this, which at that point was a Hackintosh, kind of like a Mac Pro kind of deal, I decided to make it a 24/7 Minecraft server, and also added some network shares just to add some files to it and use it as a hard drive. The thing is that that's kind of where it ended, and now I want to do some more stuff with this. Now, this doesn't have that much storage. It has 1 terabyte of SSD storage and a 500 gig hard drive. So what we're going to do is I'm going to add this 128 gig SSD as a boot drive, and then dual 500 gig hard drives for storage. And since I already have a 500 gig hard drive in here, I'm gonna join them in a RAID to hopefully have a terabyte, hopefully, of mass storage. That way I have some redundancy for my data. And also that 1 terabyte SSD is going to be for gaming and that stuff. Because when I'm currently using this, I stopped using Mac OS as a server because it is absolutely miserable. I installed Ubuntu server and I did some black magic to make a KVM and PCI Express pass-through for a GPU, so that even though I'm using a laptop, I can actually remote into this and play games on Windows, even though I use Linux. So, I'm gonna add this stuff, and I'm gonna switch the operating system. It's currently running Ubuntu server. Gone. I don't like it. I really dislike the whole config files and Docker compose. I want everything to be easy, so I've made some research, and by some I mean I just looked up on Reddit what is what people use, and my decision on what server software I'm gonna use is, you're gonna be mad about it, someone's gonna say that I'm wrong, but I'm going to be using TrueNAS Scale. It's free, it's not that easy, but it's somewhat easy to set up because it has a web interface. I've already tried it out in a virtual machine and it can do some pretty crazy stuff. Installing apps through Docker containers is extremely easy. Email notifications for like hard drive failures is so easy to install. Like, I tried following the Lewis Rossman guide on like self-hosting, which is like 900 pages long, and it's extremely verbose. Like, I don't have the time to go through that. TrueNAS Scale is gonna make it easier for me to do VMs and do Docker stuff. So we're gonna add this stuff to the computer and install a thing. Now let's take this off. It's a bit dirty, please ignore that. As you can see, we already have 2 GPUs. The SATA ports are here, and now I realized I have to get some SATA cables, so give me a moment. Okay, so unironically, I have no more SATA cables. I don't know where they went, I thought I had. Well, if you ignore this extremely disorganized room, there's nothing I can do about it. I do have this old PC, and it does have some data cables, so let's see if I have enough. And count them, 2. I'm actually missing 1. We have two cables for these 500 gig drives, but for the boot drive, we're missing one. So I'm gonna call a contact to see if he might have one. Oh my god, oh, I found the cable! Yes, I didn't know I had one. But just so you know, this is a bit of a PC building tech tip. For cables are gonna plug into your power supply, like this SATA power cable. This is a SATA power cable, you know, because it's the long one. And this plugs in to your power supply. Do not use cables from a different power supply. Power supply cables are not universal, and you can plug in the wrong one and break something. These data cables, which are the one that I stole from that PC that you saw, that is fine to do because they are just data cables, but not with power supplies. I built this PC like 5 years ago, and my skills have definitely improved since then. Ugh, this is a bit messy. Okay, now I need some way to put this on the other side. More dust! Okay, more dust to be placed in my bed. A hard drive is here, so I'm gonna probably put it on there. What the fuck did I do to this? There's a spot for an SSD here. Oh yeah, how the fuck am I gonna mount this if I have no mounting hardware? Oh, this is such a mess of cables. Okay, the fucking spaghetti of cables is all connected, but now where do I place everything? There's not a place to really mount this. That's the problem. Okay. I'm not extremely happy about it, but it is there. Yeah, we really need the redundancy when this thing, which is absolutely not mounted correctly, not screwed into everything, and literally just loose in there. When something clashes and it breaks, yeah, really gonna need that redundancy. Okay, that's the fire. Will this thing close? No way, this closed! Okay, so for test of fire, almost literally, I don't want this to catch on fire. Since this is a literal bed, that would be the worst thing ever. So, since this is already full of dust, and I'm gonna have to change the bed sheets, skateboard. I'm gonna place this computer on top of a skateboard to elevate it, so that if it catches fire, it doesn't automatically combust my entire bed and, you know, kill the house. That would be terrible, and oh my god, that is not stable. Okay, good enough. Hey, didn't explode. That's Linux. Okay, so I'm gonna take a quick shower because it is the middle of summer, and for the quality of the audio in this video, I have to turn off the fan, so I am absolutely sweating my balls off right now. I'm gonna take a shower, and we're gonna finish the installation of now the software.
After my shower, I place the server under my bed, where it's gonna live. But when I booted up the TrueNAS installer, two of my drives were not showing up. So I had to pull back the server again and reposition the SATA cables. Turns out that those ports get disabled when you have an SSD in the slot where I had one. Then it did work, and I proceeded with the installation. After some minutes, I was in the configuration for the OS. I wanted to assign a static IP address, and that was a mess. First, I couldn't figure out what the settings meant. Like, what does alias mean for an address? I then tried to just log into my router's config page and set a DHCP reservation. It didn't work. And turns out you can just set a static IP address from the web UI. So I did my first login to the server and set the address. And it worked.
Okay, it took a bit of a while, but we finally have everything ready. So I'm gonna open the thing that made me install this operating system, the web UI. Now my temps are not great. This is better than usual. It's usually like at 80 degrees, so hopefully it's not much of a problem. Anyways, we have to set up our storage first. So I think we have to storage, of course, create pool. And we have three unassigned 500 gig drives. That is what we need. This 1 terabyte one, I still don't want to do anything with because I have some data, and then we're gonna transfer it over to our new storage pool. So I'm gonna, name it data. So since this operating system uses ZFS, we have a lot of RAID options, and I'm gonna use a RAID Z1. So I have three disks, they're all 500 gigabytes. And RAID Z1 means that one of these drives is for parity. So I'm gonna have 1 terabyte of usable storage, which is not that much, but it's enough. And I can lose one of these drives and still have all of my data intact. I would do it better with more storage and more drives and more parity, but I have none of that. I am cheap, I don't have a lot of money, this is fine. I'm gonna select my hard drives, three, unassigned my SSD, this is fine. And then all of this is optional. I'm gonna go to review. I'm gonna have 1 terabyte of raw capacity, create pool. Okay, so now my ZFS storage pool is set up. And what I'm going to do before touching anything is I'm gonna go to system and alert settings, and I'm gonna set up email notifications so that if a drive were to fail, it's gonna send me a notification. This is a mess to set up using just bare bones Ubuntu server. I tried this out in a virtual machine, and this was the thing that actually made me want to install this. Okay, over here on email, I'm gonna select Gmail OAuth from email. I don't know, I'm just gonna say my email and log into Gmail. Yes, my personal Gmail account. We have logged in, send test email. Okay, it's not working well. Bingo.com. That's the problem, we have no name servers. Google. Email sent, let's go to my mail. Hey, here we have it, sent trist to me. And there's this message. It works. Okay, so now if a hard drive fails, I get an email. Good. And now the last step for setting my basic stuff is that I'm gonna make a Samba share. What's gonna name it? Centrist data. Purpose. Okay, I don't even know my own life's purpose. I don't know what this is. Warm? It's default, I don't know. Consider creating a data set instead. Okay, I'm gonna make it Centrist data. TrueNAS? No, not TrueNAS. It should be called config service. No, Centrist, please. Centrist. Hello? Yes, it works. It works. This is working first try. I am so happy. Okay, this is going unexpectedly great. And so I continued by installing Docker containers. TrueNAS sorts them as apps and sorts all the pre-built containers into a sort of app store. You select one, type some passwords, configure whatever needs to be configured, and there you have it, you have a Docker container. The ones I installed are these. I have Crafty, which is a Minecraft server, Flame, a homepage for my services, Immich, which is a Google Photos clone, Jellyfin, which is a legally sourced Netflix clone, Next Level is basically Google Drive, and Tailscale is a VPN so I can access the server remotely. The important one is Immich. I have imported all of my photo library to it, which is about 13,000 files and about 150 gigs. And I have set it up on my phone to do automatic backups to the server. And thanks to Tailscale, I can do backups and look at the photos without being on the network. There's also Jellyfin. I haven't taken the time to set up the transcoding and everything, and I tried it on my TV and it didn't work, but I imported the whole of How I Met Your Mother and it sorted all of the episodes correctly all in one go. Nextcloud has been pretty useless. Since I've already had the SMB share, that's where I place all of my remote access files. I also did install Contacts and Notes, but I recently switched to iOS and I'd rather just use the built-in apps. Also, remember the SSD that I left out for the gaming VM? Well, I was gonna say that it didn't work, but I have pulled the stupidest setup to make it finally work. So if you try to install Windows normally by uploading the ISO, it will not recognize the hard disk, the ISO, anything. The only way to make it work is by getting yourself an Ubuntu system, installing some fuck-ass program that patches in the virtual drivers, and bring whatever it gives you to the VM. Only after that complicated-ass process that I absolutely got from a forum post, did I actually manage to get Windows running. So, has the server been worth it? Yes! It's been great to be able to store all my projects somewhere else, so I don't have to worry about keeping free space on my internal drive. And I don't need to spend anything for Apple's overpriced storage upgrades. On the SSD, I made another share dedicated for video editing. And so far, the connection speed for directly editing with the footage from there has not been a bottleneck. I shoot at 1080p, 40 megabit per second bitrate. And the gigabit Ethernet has not been a bottleneck. It is amazing to have all of my photos all accessible from wherever I am without having to give all my personal images to a big company. And I don't have to keep paying every single month for some other service. I already paid for the hardware, so I get to keep it, and I don't have to pay every month to keep my data from being deleted. Also, searching on Immich is pretty good. Like, I can type in Nintendo DS and it will actually bring me Nintendo DS's. On basically anything else that doesn't work. The Windows VM has also been pretty great. I can now finally game from my shitty laptop. But anti-cheat ruins it a bit. I can play Counter-Strike, and I've played a lot of GTA 5, but I cannot play GTA Online because the anti-cheat kicks me out because it doesn't like virtual machines. Regardless, it's been a success. It truly is something that I use every single day of my life. Now, you don't need as high a spec as I have, and also don't want you to think that I'm spending here thousands of dollars on servers. This is just the mid-range gaming PC that I bought 5 years ago. And all hard drives come from laptops that I've literally gotten for free. I'll probably make a video on how to do this on the cheap because you really don't have to spend that much money to make this. The noise is something that could be better, but it's August and there's not a single moment in the day that the ceiling fan is not turned on, so I'm already pretty used to the noise. Also, I'd rather have a less power-hungry machine that doesn't kick out as much heat. But hey, it's extremely useful. So, that's it. Thank you for watching. Hopefully, the next video won't be 3 months later. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.